This is Jimmy. Jimmy and his parents met with a doctor to get help to understand why he has specific health and learning problems. The doctor decided he was a good candidate for a new genetic test called exome sequencing. If you imagine our genetic material, or DNA code, as a very large instruction manual, it would fill about 1 million pages. The exon is part of a gene that, if changed or altered, can cause health problems. All the exons together are the exome. The exome makes up about 1% of the DNA code, or 10,000 pages of our million-page book. Exome sequencing is like examining those 10,000 pages, one letter at a time, to see if there are changes like typos. The exome is important to look at, because most genetic diseases are caused by changes or alterations in the exome. A blood sample was drawn from Jimmy for this test. Jimmy's parents understood there was a 20 to 30% chance that exome sequencing would reveal a genetic diagnosis for his specific issues. There is also a chance the test might reveal other genetic changes, referred to as secondary findings. These secondary findings are also sometimes called additional or incidental findings. A secondary finding is when a gene change is found that is completely unrelated to the original reason why the testing was done, which increases Jimmy's risk for another disease. Secondary findings are found in about 3 to 5% of people undergoing exome sequencing. This means that the majority of people having this test do not have a secondary finding. In other words, regardless if exome sequencing provides a genetic reason for Jimmy's health problems, there remains a 1 in 20 chance that an unexpected disease-causing gene change could be uncovered. Secondary findings can be upsetting, often because we are not expecting them. For instance, some secondary findings may reveal a risk for a disease that will not impact Jimmy as a child, but may impact his health as an adult. This information can lead to early diagnosis or a possible treatment that may improve Jimmy's health and well-being. An example of a secondary finding that may be unexpectedly detected in exome sequencing is a gene change that increases the risk for a heart rhythm condition, which causes fast, irregular heartbeats that can trigger a sudden fainting spell or seizure. In some cases, this condition can cause an irregular heartbeat for so long that it causes sudden death. This heart condition is treatable with certain medications and, in some cases, surgery. Another example of a secondary finding is a gene change that can lead to an increased risk for colon cancer. In most cases, the symptoms for colon cancer do not begin until a person is in their 40s, so this finding would not impact Jimmy as a child, but is important information for his future health. Screening by a test called colonoscopy is 90% effective in detecting the early signs of colon cancer. These are only a couple of examples of secondary findings leading to a risk for a specific disease. Usually, the only secondary findings that are reported by the laboratory are those that can be treated or managed. Gene changes that cause secondary findings can be inherited. This information could be helpful for Jimmy, his parents, and other family members who may be at risk and could benefit from this knowledge. It is important to also remember that a negative exome sequencing result does not rule out all health issues or genetic disease. No matter what the outcome of Jimmy's testing, his parents would have an opportunity to review the results with his doctor or genetic counselor and discuss if other testing or specialty referrals should be considered. Thank you again for watching. We have other videos you may be interested in. Just go to the Center for Genetic Medicine website to learn more.